ranger, and Death Valley's my stamping ground. Many's the tale of adventure I'm going to tell you about the Death Valley country. True stories, mind you. I can vouch for that. My story tonight is about one of the most talked of characters in the old Comstock camp of Gold Hill, Nevada. Back in 1869, they called her the Diamond Babe. Even solid citizens like Herb Grimshaw, head of the Miners Union, Hank Pettibone, superintendent of the Eclipse Mine, and Otto Griffin, fire chief, can be found admiring the babe's talents. Not to mention the newcomer, Keith McIntyre.
Pound.
Hey, boys, we got the Bank of England with us. Yay! Are you a duke or something?
No, just a second son out from London. A remittance man.
Remittance, eh? Hey, Nick, bring us a drink. Well, let's go back here where it's easier to talk. I've met a lot of different kinds of men in my life, but you're a new one to me. What's your name, handsome?
Keith McIntyre.
Well, I'll call you Mac till I get to know you better. Then there's no telling what I'll call you. Start remitting, Mac. Now, tell me some more about this remittance stuff. What's it mean?
Well, a remittance man is a second son who's shipped out of the country so the first son can be given the title.
Is that good or bad?
Depends on the point of view. You see, the estate goes with the title.
Well, that don't seem fair to me. After all, it's not your fault you was born second. It's your parents.
Well, that's the custom in England.
Kind of looks like you need this more than I do.
Oh, no, no. I'll make money out here, plenty of it. On my own.
Now you're talking like an American. But let me give you a steer. Don't waste your time prospecting for gold or silver. You prospect for water.
Water?
Scarcest thing there is in Gold Hill.
You're pulling my leg.
Hmm? Any leg pulling done around here is usually...
I mean, you're joking.
Oh! Ha. No, I'm giving it to you straight. You see, there's a water shortage. And it gets worse as the town gets bigger. Time's not far off when water rights will be as valuable as mining rights. So you hunt for water instead of gold.
I say, that's awfully decent of you, to tip me off like that.
I'll get it back. Don't worry.
Meanwhile, on that same afternoon, the Ladies' Improvement Society of Gold Hill was gathered to welcome the new schoolteacher, Laura Latham.
Although this is not a regular meeting, I feel that it would not be amiss for us to take advantage of the opportunity to discuss possible group projects. You don't mind, Miss Latham?
Oh, no, indeed, Mrs. Grimshaw. I mean, Madam President.
Has anyone any suggestions? Yes, Mrs. Pettibone.
I'd like to see us raise some money for a nice hearse.
A hearse?
Yes, to take the place of that bare freight wagon we use for funerals.
It would raise the tone of Gold Hill, I grant you, Mrs. Pettibone. But personally, I feel that the living need our attention far more than the dead.
I wish we could do something to beautify the streets. Perhaps plant trees and little lawns in front of our houses.
You forget the water shortage, Mrs. Griffin.
They'd all die.
I withdraw the motion.
However, there is something that we could do to improve our streets, and that is to keep certain individuals off them, like that creature from the melodeon, the Diamond Babe. I met her the other day taking the air quite publicly, in broad daylight. We passed that close to one another.
Women like that should be tarred and feathered.
At least they should remain invisible.
Excuse me for asking, but who is this Diamond Babe?
Let's just say that she's, an undesirable.
Oh.
As head of the miners' union, Mr. Grimshaw's word carries great weight amongst the men, and I know that he will support any action we decide to take.
As superintendent of one of the biggest mines in Gold Hill, Mr. Pettibone also wields considerable influence, and we can count on his cooperation.
With my husband as chief of the Gold Hill Fire Department, I'm sure the men will follow his lead.
Company, halt!
Where's the fire?
Right there, the hottest thing in town.
Yeah, try and put me out.
Oh, no, we're taking you in, babe. Diamond Babe, at a meeting of the Gold Hill Fire Company, it was unanimously voted that we elect you honorary fire chief.
And here's your certificate, duly signed, sealed, and delivered.
Honorary fire chief, Gold Hill Fire Department. Boys, I'm thrilled to death. Well, how do I look?
Hey!
Three cheers for the fire queen!
Ray! Ray! Ray!
Elbows on the bar, boys. The drinks are on me.
What's the matter, Herb? Quit drinking?
No. Well, I gotta get home. My wife's having company for supper, and she warned me not to be late. And whether he likes it or not, I've got orders to bring Keith with me.
I'll see you again.
Sure, anytime. The door's always open.
I made those sponge cakes for the Ladies' Improvement Society that met here this afternoon.
Whom do you improve?
Not themselves. They couldn't be improved upon.
Never mind the sarcasm, Herbert.
Are you a member, Miss Latham?
Well, being new here, you might say more an honorary member.
Well, that's interesting. You're the second honorary member I've met today. The gentleman of the fire department was.
Sorry, I choked on a cake crumb. Tell Keith about your society, Luella.
We work to improve the manners, morals, and general tone of the town. Which reminds me, Herbert, that we are commissioning you to approach that, creature and insist that henceforth she restrict herself to her own, bailiwick.
What are you talking about, Luella? The Diamond Babe.
The woman we're speaking of is an entertainer.
Who's covered with diamonds, I understand. Paste, of course.
Paste? Why, I didn't think that...
Sorry. Can't come again. You were saying, my dear?
She has been circulating quite publicly of late, taking the air in broad daylight.
Well, it's hardly up to me, my dear, to tell her when and where she can breathe.
Well, if you won't, then Otto Griffin will use his influence as head of the fire department.
This is the crummiest cake I ever ate.
I don't see how anyone as small and pretty as you can ever keep order in that room full of pupils.
I make up with a paddle for what I lack in size.
Good afternoon.
Hello.
That must have been the Diamond Babe.
Quite.
You spoke to her.
Right.
Mr. McIntosh.
She calls me Mac. But I'd rather you called me Keith.
You know her?
We've met.
What is she like?
No, don't tell me. I'd rather not know. All those diamonds, it's indecent.
You still think they're paste?
I'll take my books now, if you'll be so kind.
I expect you know everything that's in these.
After all, I am a teacher.
But you still have a lot to learn.
What you need is a divining rod. You walk along, holding it over the ground, and when you come to water, it begins to waggle. So.
Where do I buy one?
You don't. You cut it from a witch hazel bush. And I can tell you where there's a clump of them growing. Right up Gold Canyon, about. Say, better yet, I'll take you there myself.
Now?
Well, there's no time like the present.
But...
Oh, that's all right. You don't have to be seen with me. We can leave town separate.
It's you I'm thinking of.
Me?
I'd hate to have you run into any unpleasantness.
What's the Ladies' Improvement Society up to now? I suppose they'd like me to wear a veil over my face when I appear in public?
No, no.
Or perhaps not appear at all?
It's ridiculous, of course.
Well, thanks for telling me. So they're daring me, eh? Well, just for that, I'll double dare them.
Obviously, my husband spoke to her, Mrs. Pettibone, but she hasn't set foot on the street since.
How do you know?
I've been patrolling.
Oh, well, I think we owe both Mr. and Mrs. Grimshaw a vote of thanks. Will you tell your husband for us?
I will indeed, when he comes in. He's at a meeting at the moment. At the firehouse.
They all are.
Mr. McIntyre has joined the engine company, too.
How nice. Well, now that we've accomplished that much, good ladies, I think that... That settles it. That woman's got to leave Gold Hill altogether.
Gold Hill was full of husbands in the doghouse that night. And what Mrs. Grimshaw said to Herb was practically the same thing that Sybil said to Hank. And Amelia said to Otto. But with Laura and Keith, it was Keith who did most of the talking, trying to square himself.
The divining rod began to behave strangely, and bless my soul, there only a few feet underground was water. I filed straight away, of course, and you're not listening.
Hmm? Oh, yes, I am. You filed.
And tomorrow I shall go to the Gold Hill Water Company and arrange either to sell or lease. And half of what I get's going to be yours for instructing me. Well, I say, you're acting rather queerly.
Are you put out with me?
No, of course not. I was just thinking about Nick, my bartender.
What did he do?
He died today.
Died?
Went just like that a couple of hours ago.
What was it?
I haven't any idea. He complained of a bad headache and pains in his chest. The next thing we knew, he'd folded.
Oh, I say, that's too bad.
Do you know anything about medicine?
Medicine? Why, no.
Why? Tom Gunn died a little while ago, and I...
Tom Gunn?
First, we thought it was ptomaine poisoning, but ptomaine don't work that fast.
Did he have pains?
Yeah. Head and chest. Had trouble breathing. It was all over before we could do anything for him.
Nick died the same way today.
Nick?
Johnny, have you seen Herb Grimshaw around?
He's right over there.
I never saw anybody go so fast.
Herb, we've got some trouble up at the mine. Tiny Dunlap just died.
Dunlap?
From what?
I don't know. Complained of feeling choked. Sort of like he was smothering. And four of the other boys have got the same thing.
First Nick, then Tom Gunn, now Tiny Dunlap.
It must be something contagious.
Yeah, but what? And what do we do for it?
Well, it sounds like the same thing that hit Cripple Creek when I was bartending there.
How'd you treat him?
Well, the best thing we found was to put him to bed and feed him plenty of soup.
Hank, bring those sick men here. Get bunks to put them on.
You bet, babe.
Herb, you check the other mines. Bring in any sick man who hasn't got somebody to look after him. You girls, make the rounds to all the families. If you find anybody laid up, pour them full of soup.
Anything I can do?
Yes. Tell your teacher friend to close the school and send the kids home.
Right.
Here, Johnny. Put these in the safe for me. Looks like I won't be needing them for a while.
Sure, babe. Laura, I was just coming to see you.
After seeing her, I noticed.
Stop being a prude and listen to me. A strange sickness, an epidemic, has hit this town. Already several people have died, and the Diamond Babe wants you to close the school.
I'm in charge of the school, and I'll do as I think best.
You'll do as she says. It's only common sense.
Very well. And it's also common sense that you don't call on me anymore.
Sweet little school teacher.
I heard Mr. McIntyre was sick.
That's right.
Well, I came to take care of him.
Aren't you afraid of catching the sickness yourself?
Not any more than you are.
Oh, what do you know? Maybe I was wrong about you.
What do I do?
For him, nothing. I'm having him moved over to the saloon with the rest of the men. But if you really want to help, you can turn your schoolroom into a hospital for the sick women. It's easier to take care of them all in one place.
Gotten a hearse for this town.
Well, where are you ladies going? I ask you where you're going.
Not that it's any business of yours, but we're going to Carson City until this epidemic is over.
Well, isn't that nice? You've been harping about improvements in this town. Now you're running out on the only chance you'll ever have to do some improving.
We have discussed the matter with our husbands, and they have agreed this would be best.
I can imagine how much discussing you did.
We shall pray for the sick every day.
If you had any gumption, you'd do your praying here and nurse them at the same time. Three of my girls are sick and I can use some help.
But we could get the sickness ourselves.
And you could save the lives of some who already have it. People you used to call your friends. But if it doesn't make any difference to you, go ahead, get on that stage. Run away.
Driver, unload those bags. Mrs. Pettibone and I have changed our minds about leaving.
Yes, these poor unfortunate people here need us.
In the weeks that followed, while the epidemic raged, the Diamond Babe drove herself night and day taking care of the sick, until she was almost sick herself with exhaustion. But she kept at it. And she kept her assistants busy, too. They didn't work as hard as the Babe, but they sure worked harder than they ever worked before. And for the time being, at least, there was an unspoken truce between the good ladies of the Improvement Society and the object of their disapproval. Yes, sir, night and day, the Diamond Babe drove herself. Not only in the saloon, but everywhere else that she could help those who needed it. Well, the epidemic, whatever it was, finally run its course. And once more, it was business as usual in Gold Hill.
I sure did. Come on in.
You did so well taking care of the sick people that I wondered if you'd help me out. You see, there's a fellow that I can't cure. And believe me, I've tried.
Mr. McIntyre.
Miss Latham.
Keith.
Laura.
Hill Ladies Improvement Society, we have come here to...
Look, you haven't come here to ask me to join.
Oh, no. No, indeed.
We realize you're much too busy with other activities.
Good.
Yeah. We don't want to lose the Diamond Babe.
We sure don't.
We have come here to express our appreciation of your magnificent work during the recent crisis which swept our community.
We believe in giving the devil his due.
I'll do the talking, Sybil. In recognition whereof, we have voted unanimously to present you with this scroll. Presented to the Diamond Babe, the Florence Nightingale of Gold Hill, for devotion and service to her community.
Hooray! Hooray!
The Gold Hill Ladies Improvement Society. Well, say, that's really swell. Elbows on the bar, gals. The drinks are on me. Oh, excuse me. I kind of forgot myself. Sandy, make the ladies a pot of tea. Sure looks well. Ladies, I can't tell you what this means to me. Why, now I'm not only the honorary fire chief of Gold Hill, but also the Florence Nightingale.
Three cheers for our Florence Nightingale.
Hooray! 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 Hooray!
Who's Florence Nightingale?
All of which goes to show that you can never tell where you'll find a hero or a heroine.